Meet the expert, a knowledge-sharing initiative of your knowledge partner, the developing Bangladesh. We discuss on trade, investment, commerce, education, skills, economic development, global peace and prosperity, etc. issues. If you are interested to these issues, please subscribe to the channel. Developing Bangladesh, your knowledge partner, please subscribe now.
Assalamu alaikum. Dear audience,
Walaikum
expert session of Developing Bangladesh, we usually listen from an international expert on a very specific issue. Today, I am very delighted to host Dr. Asad Soomro. He is a hydrogeologist and ecosystem developer joining from Pakistan. He will be speaking on a very important issue today. This is groundwater and rainwater harvesting. You all know, due to excessive use of groundwater, I mean underground water, in irrigation, in our daily life, in our household activities, in our industrial activities, so water level, groundwater level is going down. So scientists already alarmed us that it is alarming that groundwater level, especially in the major urban area around the globe, not only in Dhaka city or in Karachi or in Delhi, throughout the globe, while we are just using underground water through tube well, deep tube well, and other means of water collection. So excessive use of that is really throwing us towards a new challenge, because water, it is very important for livelihood, not only to drink, but also to harvest, to use in irrigation, to use in our industry and everywhere. Therefore, today, again, the scientists are suggesting us to use rainwater, to use groundwater, canal water, whatever we can. So today we will be listening on this particular issue. Before that, I would like to humbly request you, sir, could you please introduce yourself with me and my audience?
My research was concerned on groundwater. Besides groundwater in the hilly area and the flood plains, there's other things, two multiple, and not a single phase. There are two other ideology. And hilly area, there is hydrogeology is another. And then in the floodplain, there is the hydrogeology is another sense. So I will talk about both. And about for this reason, rainwater is the most precious to recharge the groundwater. Some countries, they are what doing? They are doing their home, develop their home, and roof from their home. They take one pipe and they put in the ground. And finally, they recharge the ground. And sometimes they make the tanks and they take use from that tank for lively water. So unfortunately we have damaged our soil profile by boring. Once we are boring, getting that there are no fresh water, then we leave that, and that is not a true scientific way. The scientific way where we bore and we have to refill that. I'm not refilling that area in the plain area, so that is the problem. And in also hilly area, there is the same sense. One, they are not without scientifically, technically knowing that here is the fresh water. And I used a terrameter. So from that equipment, I got the fresh water aquifer zone. In different places, not everywhere available. So that's a technical way to identify the fresh water And from the rainwater, we have to reach out that aquifer. So in this line, and from when we get the river water, and we use the river water. River water is best for irrigation, and further net water, if we have enough, then we can use for its recharging in groundwater. Everybody is in our region, and you are Bangladesh and Pakistan. We are both brothers, and we are doing the same scenario, same work, same habitual, same psychology, human psychology. So we have to understand that. From my experience in Japan and USA, they have formulated their legislation on this issue, then provide fresh water to public. Government have to, in California and USA, I am telling their rules and regulation legislation. And their government has responsibility to provide fresh water for public, for irrigation. So if anybody takes from groundwater, they have to pay government. And unfortunately, we have no any legislation to formulate this sense. So rainwater harvesting is most precious in this era, 2022 monsoonic season. We have got the heavy rainfall from Balochistan and Sindh, particular areas that got very rainfall. But in my sense, there is no flood of rainfall. We can manage it. But unfortunately, our government have not made the formulation and their rainwater harvesting. Initially, they have to develop from houses, and from then houses to go towards land areas, and land areas from their dumps and sumps, and they from their way they can recharge the groundwater. So unfortunately, we have no any legislation. I think there may be in Bangladesh there may be no any legislation about this site. So we have no, and you have no. That means we are getting problem, and we will get the problem in 2024, 2025, and there will be the big monsoonic rain, and also the river water, both we will face, and there will be very trouble. So that's why today my meeting was there about on that side. And I said that we will get the problem in 2023. So if we manage at this time, and we can do. If we not do the make any legislation about that, and we cannot make the path free path for water flow, that flow towards sea, and that flow towards groundwater recharge in different places, and that is the duty of a hydrogeologist. They know very well the geology of that soil, that hilly area, so that they can harvest and recharge their aquifer. So this is the ideology. And the ecosystem development is the best way when we are harvesting or cutting the jungles and trees. That problem is problem. So in Japan, I asked them, then Japan is an industrial country, but how they make their ecosystem. So from your country, Naim-sen was with me in 2003, from July, June, July, 2 months, 2003. Particularly, I asked them, then how you manage the ecosystem? They say that we are developing the industrial area, some about 10 hectares, then we have to establish beside that area one jungle, forest, tree. So that will manage the ecosystem from their gases, that will manage with...
Developing Bangladesh, your knowledge partner. We take care of trade and investment, education and skills, economic diplomacy and economic development. If you would like to keep you updated on these issues, please subscribe to Developing Bangladesh. Thank you very much for watching till the last.